solve that numerical first. Try to solve it. So in this numerical, what we are considering? We are considering a binary symmetry. Now let's solve that problem. So what is there? Consider a transition probability diagram of a binary symmetric channel shown in the figure. Already we know this is a figure for a binary symmetric channel. This is your inputs. This is our outputs. And we know the corresponding error probability is P. This is also same when both are same. And now, in that case, what is the input? Is your input binary symbol 0 and 1 occur with the equal probability? So that means Px0 equal to half, Px1 equal to half. Okay. Now find the probabilities of the binary symbols 0 and 1 appearing at the channel output. So we have to find out what is the probability of P of Y0 and P of Y1. Okay. So here Y0 equal to 0 and Y1 equal to 1. So now try to do this. So now tell me, what is the formula for your that probability P nor P Y not in the binary symmetric channel? What is the expression? So what is given? If we see, this is the given value, the P X not equal to P X one, and that's equal to half. Okay. So now if we want to calculate the what is the value of P Y not, so what is the expression for that? So prior P Y not, that means we need to find out what should be the probability over there. So how to calculate the probability over there? Anyone?
Sir, probability of y0 equal to 0 is 1 by 2 and equal to 1 is also 1 by 2.
Both true. So that basically the how to calculate the probability at y0. So we can say the probability of y0, that's equal to 1 minus p into probability of x0 plus p into probability of x1. So that is the equivalent probability of y0. So the y0 we can write in that way, y0 equal to 1 minus p, this 1 minus p, and the corresponding input value equal to this. So p of x0 plus the probability error over there is equal to p, and the probability of input is equal to px1. So now we know this is equal to half, this is equal to half. If we put that value, so it will become half. So this is the expression, and finally we are getting the half. So similarly, the y1, so y1 will be same. What should be the expression for the y1? I will check everyone's copy. So all of you should write this numerical on your notebook. Individually, I will ask, okay, show you. Show me your notebook. Okay. So do not forget to write those things. Don't think that yes, since sir will give this PPT, we will not do anything. Okay. So I will check everyone's. Randomly, I will ask someone and I will check. So this is the expression for your probability of y1. And similar to your probability of y0, the py1, that's equal to 1 minus p into px1 plus p into px0. So now if we know these two value, px0 and px1, if we put this value over there, what we'll get? We'll get 1 minus p into half plus p into half, and so this is equivalent to half. Okay. So now if we change that value over there, suppose both are equal probable, means equal probability, the probability of both inputs are same. Now, if we change the probability of both inputs, then how to calculate? We have to write, suppose the probability of x not equal to say 1/3 and this is 2/3. So corresponding value we have to put for calculating the py not and py on. Okay, is that clear?
Sir, in the final expression, then there will be some terms for p also.
Some terms p will be there. So now, if the probability of error is given, okay, so in this expression, the p is cancelled out. Okay, so in some cases this may happen. Definitely, when the this term is the difference, say it is 1/3, this is 2/3. Okay. So in that case, there will be a probability, means there will be the final expression y p y naught. There will be terms of p, and what is the p? P is the probability of error. So probability of error we know. So then we can find out what is the value if it is given. Otherwise, if it is not given, you just keep the final expression in top of p. Okay, so now suppose it is given for a system where the bit error rate equal to 10 to the power minus 6. Okay, suppose this question you just change x p x1 equal to 1/3 and p x1 this is equal to 2/3. Okay, and the system bit error rate for the system is given 10 to the power minus 6. Just now tell me what is the probability of py naught and what is the probability of py on. Solve it and tell me. Are you getting my question?
Sir, could you please repeat the value?
Same problem. I am changing only two things. One is the p in this equation, on in this numerical, the px naught is given half. So I am saying take px naught equal to 1/3 and px1 this equal to 2/3. And also consider the system has the bit error rate ber which is equal to 10 to the power minus 6. Now tell me what is the value of py naught and what is the value of py1. When you done, just share your means. You can do one thing. You can upload your answer over here. Okay.
Sir.
Yes.
Sir, as the bit error rate is very less, we can say that py naught is equal to px naught and py1 is equal to px1. Matlab py naught is equal to 1/3 and py1 is equal to 2/3.
You see that bit error rate means the p value is given.
Yes, sir.
P value is given. That means since p value is less, most of the data there will be no error. Okay. So
yes,
if we consider the exact value, what should be the exact value? Some error will be there. And if we consider those value, what should be the probability? Means normally it will come, this is py naught will be equal to px naught. But some different, little bit different will be there. So just solve it and show me how much difference is there. The difference is not too much. It will be in, it will come in after 4 or 5 digits. After decimal point, for after 4 or 5 digit, that value will come.
Sir, it is showing a difference after 6 digits.
After 6 digits, definitely, because 10 to the minus 6 is there. That means the difference will come after 6 digits. So, and what is the difference? That value is very less. Okay. And now if you, in some numerical, it may happen that the BER value is given 10 to their minus 2 or 10 to their minus 3. Okay. So according to that, you have to consider. Means the concept is clear how we are solving any problem regarding the binary symmetric channel.
So can you once again tell why was the requirement of binary symmetric channel? I forgot.
You see that normally what the when you discuss about the channel, so we have seen there are many input channel means input symbols is the maybe, and there are many output symbols also is there. Okay. So when we consider the digital communication, in the digital communication we transmit either 0 and 1. So either 0 and 1 means that is the binary channel. Okay. And since both the probability are same, means occurring when we transmitting the 0, the probability of occurring 1 at the output is same as the when we transmitting bit 1 and receiving bit 0, both have the same probability. That's why it is symmetric. And this kind of channel is called the binary symmetric channel. Okay.
Okay, sir.
Okay. So now go to the next problem. Here we will consider the mutual information. We will calculate the mutual information. Okay. Try to solve it. First, note down that numerical. Anyone, how much progress you have done? Do you start to solve the problem?
So one doubt,
yes.
The px0 value should be here is given by the period probability of symbol 1 at the input channel. This means px0 should be equal to p1, na?
Over in this problem?
Yes, sir. The second line of the problem.
Okay. So what is there? Second line of the problem for the mutual information of the channel as a function of P1 and period probability symbols 1 of the channel. So actually this is given, what is the value of your PX1? Okay. So definitely from there you have to calculate, because what is the expression for your mutual information? The expression IX, Y.
Yes, sir.
So first you just do one thing here, that you consider those value and try to find out the joint probability. And we know what is the expression for the joint probability also. So we can find out that way. And P naught, you can write P naught equal to 1 minus P1. Any progress? Okay, let me start the solving. So what we are doing, first this is the expression for your mutual information, we know that. Okay, so in this expression that p x j y k, that is your joint probability. Okay. So basically we need to find out what is the value of those joint probability. Okay. So now if we want to calculate the joint probability over there, and you see in this, since it is a binary symmetric channel, we consider two input and two output, means both j equal to 0 to 1, k equal to 0 to 1. If there are many number of inputs and output, according to that we have to change the expression. But since it is given that it is a binary symmetric channel, we consider j equal to 0 to 1, k equal to 0 to 1. Okay, and this is the expression for this. So that means using these two j and k, how many combination is possible? J have two value, k have two value. Okay, so using this j and k, how many combination we can get?
Four
combination we can get. J equal to 0, k equal to 0, j equal to 0, k equal to 1, j equal to 1, k equal to 0, j equal to 1, k equal to 1. So in this four case, what you have to do, you have to find out what is the joint probability and what is the individual probability. So now just check one by one, what is the joint probability when we consider for different four value. So for the different four value, j equal to k equal to 0, means both are 0. So the joint probability p x 0 y 0, and what is that value? That's equal to p 0 into 1 minus p. Okay, so you can get that value from your joint probability theorem is over there in the binary symmetric channel. Okay, so you just go to the PBS. In this figure, what is the joint probability over there? So the joint probability in this point, p 1 minus p, p is the transition probability, and into p x naught. So we have done the same thing here, p x naught into 1 minus p, transition probability, and p naught, that's equal to 1 minus p1, because summation of all probability at the input will be equal to 0, e1. So that means p0 plus p1 equal to 1. So that means we can write p0 equal to 1 minus p1, and 1 minus p is already there. Now similarly, if you want to find out what is the value for this, j equal to 0, k equal to 1, that means we want to find out when we are giving an input x naught and we are getting output y1. That means when we sending bit 0 and we are getting bit 1 at the receiver. So the probability, what should be the probability? P naught into P. If you see the binary symmetric channel figure, what is the probability over here due to this? The P naught into P, this transition probability. So we'll getting the p naught into p, and again we replacing the p naught equal to 1 minus p1. So similarly, we will get these two value when j equal to 1, k equal to 0, and j equal to 1, k equal to 1. So in this expression, what do we do? We consider the p naught equal to p x naught and p1 equal to p x1. Is that clear up to this?
So p naught should be equal to p1 now, because it is symmetric.
P naught equal to p1.
Symmetric channel, you said, no, sir, that probability of occurrence of x y1 from x0 is same as probability of occurrence of y0 from x1.
No. You got confused over there. So that probability of occurrence, that means transition probability are same, this thing. But when we considering the input probability, these two may have the different probability. As I considered the previous case, 1 by 3 and 2 by 3. So this is two things, is the, this is the input probability, and the probability of error means when we sending 0 and getting 1, the probability is p, transition probability. And similarly, when we sending 1 or we are getting 0, the probability also 1, a p. So in this kind of, both are p, that type of channel is called the symmetric channel. Is that clear? Don't confused with this. Okay. So similarly, if we put those value, we'll get that all the joint probabilities. Okay. Is that clear up to this? Is there any doubt? No doubt. Good. Yes.
Hello. In P x1 comma y1, the probability of getting y1 given x1 should be 1 minus p.
1 minus p. Okay. Let's check when we are sending x1 and y1. So that means when we this condition over the probability is there, how much? So what is the probability over there? This is your equal to p1. Into what is the transition probability in this line? 1 minus p, that means whatever the joint probability will get, p1 into 1 minus p. So you check, we are writing this or not? Okay, one mistake maybe I have done. 1 minus p. Okay, that symbol is changed over there. Okay, so you just change it. Some mistake is there, so that the value is changed over there. Do you get it?
Yes.
So this is p1 and it will be 1 minus p, so that value is changed. Okay, theek hai na? Now how we are calculating this, if you see, if there is any problem, we can get the joint probability directly from here. Okay, so joint probability in here, when y x equal to 1, y equal to 1, so in that case this is the multiplication of this probability into the transition probability. So this is p1 and this is 1 minus p. Okay, so since I have done a mistakes over there, in the next expression there may miss, next expression onwards there may be a mistake. Okay, actually somehow when I writing this thing, it interchange the value. Okay, you have to rectify those thing. So now if we put all those value over there, what we will get? So it will be your p for different value of this. What should be the expression? We can write that expression for different value. Okay, but in this expression I think we have written the right thing, p1 into 1 minus p. I hope that that here I did the mistake when j equal to 1, k equal to 1, but if you look at that, when j equal to 1 and k equal to 1, so but in this case we have written the right expression. The expression is correct, is it?
So we have eliminated p naught, means we have written every terms in terms of p1.
P1, yeah, because you see, it is written the plot the mutual information of the channel as a function of p1, not in term of p naught. That's why we are replacing all those p naught value. Okay. Okay. So now we replace all those value over there. And finally, if we place all those value, and if there is a, like here also, when j equal to 0, we will get px 0, and we have to put the corresponding value. And if we place all those value, so finally we will get this expression. Okay, so this whole expression we will get. So now, is there any doubt up to this point how we are getting? Over here. Okay. So note down this expression, final expression that we are getting. X equal I x comma y, that is the final expression we are getting. So now if we simplify that expression, because since all the expression there are P1 and P is there, so definitely some terms will be cancelled out and we can simplify this thing. Yes or no? So now if we simplify this thing, what we will get? We will get that expression. Okay, finally, the mutual information expression, we will get this. If we do all the mathematics over there and rearrange and expand the algorithm, and we will get the final expression is that. Okay, and you check you are getting this expression or not from there. Okay.
So do we need to simplify? Can't we leave up to the second last step?
So you see, if you for this either skip some steps over there. Now, if you do, is it not easy to remember those expression? So if you try to jump those expression, suppose when we are getting this expression from there, when you are simplifying this expression, if you step jump some steps, what will happen? That you will not be get, maybe you may write, sometimes there is a difficult to get the exact expression, but since I solve and I am putting in the your PPT, so I skip some steps over here. So if just do note down these two expression and try to find out the fine, you are getting the final expression from here or not, you just let me know in the next class. Okay. So note down this final expression. What is we are getting the mutual information. Okay. Now if we look at the question, what is there? So do your calculation for the transition different value of the transition probability. So now if we replace all those values for different transition probability, what we will get? First one, p equal to 0. So now if we p equal to 0, put p equal to 0 over there, because different values of p is given. If we replace p equal to 0, what will be expression we will get when we will p equal to 0? Ix comma y, that's equal to minus p1 log 2 base p1 minus 1 minus p1 into log 1 minus p1. So that expression we will get. Now, since we are considering over here that both generating the input symbols, that means x 0 and 1 are same equal equiprobal, means both are equal probability of having those value, generating those value 0 and 1. So that's why we have considered if in this case p1 equal to 0.5. So that means P0 will be equal to 0.5 also. The binary symmetric channel, in the binary symmetric channel, we consider both are equal probability, both probability of both inputs are same. So in that case, we got the 1 by 2, that means 0.5. If we place the P in this expression, P1 equal to 0.5, we are getting the Ix, y, that's equal to 1. Now the next, when we get have the p equal to 0.1, what should be the value? Just tell me. In that case also you consider p1 equal to 0.5. Okay, so that will be the expression I x comma y, that's equal to, if we put all those value in this expression, we will get that. Okay, And if we put P1 equal to 0.5, then finally we'll get the mutual information value that's equal to 0.531. Okay. Is there any doubt how we are doing this? Anyone have any doubt? So similarly, we can find out the different mutual information value for different transition probability. And if we see the condition, the transition probability means mutual information will be zero when the transition probability equal to 0.5. Okay.
So will that always be the case?
When P, this may vary depending on the systems. So for the binary systems, when your P not equal to P equal to 1.5, if you see, so if P equal to 1.5, what is the expression? What we are getting from here? Okay.
Sir, can you means once again tell about the significance of mutual information means?
So that means the what is a mutual information? Basically, mutual information is that when we have some inputs and we are want to calculate what should be the corresponding output. So that means in the inputs there is a probability for all the input symbols. And in the output also some output probability is there. Means we can calculate the what should be the output probability if we see the over there in this figure. So suppose we are considering the binary channel. So in the binary channel, the inputs have some probability, output have some probability. So now that means when we are sending a symbols, there must be some information. Yes or no? So now the how the information is related with the input and y output. Okay. So that is the means when we are sending some output value means output, we are getting some output based on the some inputs. That means we can say there is some mutuality is there, like in machine, you have studied the mutual inductor, mutual capacitor, those things you study now. So similar thing is there. When there is an input, there is a mutual information is there, because when we are generating a symbols, there is a, it's not like that all the symbols have the 100% of information. Because we have seen when we discuss about the entropy, and there is a all time there is a not a 100% information is there. Okay, so that's why that when we are transmitting some bits, we need to find out how much information is there. Okay, so that thing we are doing over here, the mutual, how much mutual information at the output when there is a some given inputs is there. Okay, is that clear?
Yes.
Okay, so this is the so result for those. Okay, now I will ask someone that just show me your notebooks. How many of you have note down this thing? Okay, let me cross this thing.